GBTV has been really, really good lately. The shows have just been off the charts. Last night was an epic monologue. Last night, the first 40 minutes of the show, and it did involve a sledgehammer and a blood pressure cuff, but it was very satisfying. Oh, and Barack Obama in a Mao outfit. But the truth has no agenda, right? The truth shall set you free. One of our golden rules here. The truth has no agenda. A lot of times the truth kind of winds up hurting my side of the argument short term. Sometimes a person that I trust or believe in screws up royal. Sometimes there's a dirtbag that's supposedly working to advance principles that I agree with. And then, you know, it doesn't work out real well. And then what happens? Usually the people on your side of the argument will say, "Would you just shut up? You're hurting the party. You're hurting this or whatever." And you're like, "No, truth has no agenda. Shh. Tell the truth all the time." Now, with that in mind, I want to make sure we cover the latest in a series of emails that has just been released by the whistleblower who is on the inside during the massive BP oil spill. They came out right before Thanksgiving. The story could easily be buried because of this. I mean, you know, so I wanted to address it. I don't think that oil companies are evil. You know that. But I want you to look at these emails sent from executives, safety experts, staff scientists at the very top of BP and Halliburton and many of their supporters on the right. Now, let me just go through a couple of them. I'm going to read them verbatim. Quote, "Would you agree there's no convincing evidence that these platforms are safe for the people on them, let alone for the surrounding wildlife?" Question that came in to one of the BP people. Quote, "I find myself being very skeptical of the quality of the platform safety specs, yet I'm sounding like a pro-oil zealot here." End quote. "This is downright dangerous. We need to communicate the uncertainty and be honest." Here's another one. "One way to cover yourself would be delete all these emails at the end of the process," end quote. Now, that's pretty, I mean, isn't that pretty open and shut?
Pretty damning.
Pretty damning. You immediately, if I'm sitting in front of a jury and I'm hearing these emails, they show me these emails, BP is done. They're done. So why hasn't the media covered these? You'd think that NBC, ABC, CNN, CBS, MSNBC would find a way to expose these incredibly shady hidden emails by higher-ups at BP and Halliburton. The reason why they haven't covered them is because the ones that I just read from Halliburton and BP don't exist, at least not from them. Actually, these are exact quotes in emails from the world-leading climate scientist about global warming. I just changed the topics. It's Climategate 2.0, the latest release of private emails from the engine of the global climate scare. The highest profile scientist in the middle of the world's highest profile merger of science and politics. You know how they sound in public. How they're all saying this, the science is settled. It's got to use this way. You got to be. But how are they talking to each other in private? In public, there's no doubt. Any questioning equivalent to the Holocaust denial. You just have Barbara Boxer saying you're endangering all of humankind. But in private, here are the actual emails. Climategate 2, quote, "The science is being manipulated to put a political spin on it. Might not be too clever in the long run," end quote. Quote, "I find myself being very skeptical of the quality of all the reconstructions, yet sounding like a pro-greenhouse zealot here," end quote. Quote, "It's just downright dangerous. We need to communicate the uncertainty and be honest," end quote. Quote, "Basic problem is all the models are wrong. There's not enough middle and low level clouds," end quote. Quote, what if climate change appears to just be mainly a multi-decadal natural fluctuation? They'll kill us probably," end quote. Quote, "There have been a number of dishonest presentations of model results by individual authors and by the IPCC," end quote. quote, "We need to convince readers that there really has been an increase in knowledge, more evidence. What is it?" End quote. In public, Al Gore was saying this. Another friend of mine, go ahead and say, just read this part right here. Another friend of mine, Lonnie Thompson.
Mm-hmm. Another friend of mine, Lonnie Thompson, studies glaciers. Here's Lonnie with a sliver of a once mighty, with a sliver. I'm sorry, it's not a silver, it's a sliver. Here's Lonnie with a sliver of a once mighty glacier. Within the decade, there will be no more snows of Kilimanjaro.
Okay, got it? You know, this is the whole Kilimanjaro thing.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
This email exchange is actually specifically discussing how Lonnie Thompson, the same guy in the Al Gore picture, isn't finding the warming necessary to support the claims. And here's what he said. "Would you agree there is no convincing evidence for Kilimanjaro melt being due to recent warming, let alone man-made warming?"
I mean, that's the exact opposite of what these guys were saying in public.
Wow.
Exact opposite.
Wow. On CNN, when I was over on CNN, I had John Christie on Headline News. And his quote was, "Half the snow was gone when Hemingway wrote The Snows of Kilimanjaro," end quote. That tells you right there that the cause of the snow melt was not human effects on climate. There is no upward trend in temperatures for that region. That's a quote from him. In public, scientists tell us they're not hiding anything, but in private, quote, "One way to cover yourself? Delete all the emails at the end of this process." Quote, "Any work we've done in the past is done in the back of a research grant that we got. It has to be well hidden," end quote. Quote, the government wants the story to be a very strong one and don't want to be made to look foolish, end quote. Quote, "Somehow we have to leave them thinking, okay, climate change is extremely complicated, but I accept that people are affecting it," end quote. Quote, "I'm not convinced that this truth," in quotation marks, "is always worth reaching if it's at the cost of a damaged personal relationship," end quote. In public, scientists criticize supposed propaganda from the evil oil companies, but in private, they admit they're depending on it. Quote, 500 million people are expected to watch the day after tomorrow. We have to pray that they pick up the message. Well, at least here they're praying. Al Gore used footage from the day after tomorrow in his documentary film.
Yeah, forget about that. Yeah. Mm-hmm.
These emails are from a batch of 5,000 out of the over 200,000 that supposedly exist. We don't yet know who is releasing them. Is it a whistleblower on the inside? Is it a hacker of some sort? If it is a hacker, it's illegal and wrong, and the ends don't justify the means. Theft is theft. But why will no one cover it? And you need to be informed on what the truth is about climate change and how Barbara Boxer is lying yet again. The only thing threatening humankind are humans and their lives.